Ponda Tadakazu says if it hadn't been for Christians, he would have abandoned the seaweed factory that's been in his family for three generations.
If they had come a month after the tsunami, I wouldn't have made it, but they came 2 weeks later and started helping me clean up.
His company sits less than 500 yards from the ocean. 30 minutes after the earthquake, multiple tsunamis swept through his factory, destroying everything. Thanks to the help from Christians like Koji Oshima, he's only months away from reopening his company.
Since the earthquake, the Holy Spirit has been telling me to travel around the affected areas and help people get back on their feet.
It's a story that's been played out across Japan's tsunami-affected areas. Churches and individual Christians moved quickly in those early days and are still working to help the displaced and hurting. On March 11th last year, moments before the earthquake, Yokoyama Daisuke and a handful of Christians gathered in Tokyo for a prayer meeting.
A few young people met that afternoon to pray and cry out to God to bring a spirit of repentance and revival to our nation, and then the earthquake happened.
Within minutes, they started ministering to grief-stricken and frightened people.
Once again, at Kamaishi City, and
you watched the drama unfold on television screens.
We went to the subway and train stations where thousands of people were stranded. We served coffee and tea and tried to share hope with the people.
In the 12 months since the disaster, Yokoyama left Tokyo and moved here, some 25 miles from the Fukushima nuclear plant, where he's using worship to share the gospel with non-believers.
People are coming to the Lord. They see love and compassion displayed by Christians, and they're touched.
Domai Shogo is one of them. A former gang member, he spent 22 years in prison for multiple infractions. Last November, he got an invitation to attend Yokoyama's church, and he gave his life to Jesus Christ. Today, you'll find him making friends among the thousands displaced by the earthquake and tsunami.
And while tremendous progress has been made the past 12 months, the reality is that tens of thousands are still homeless. And so the government has set up temporary shelters like this one. But so many people are looking for a place to call home again.
I spend my time listening to their stories. These are very lonely people who have lost everything. So I'm here to show them the love of Christ and to tell them how he changed my life.
A theme echoed this past weekend.
Did you know that God has a plan for your life?
As Japanese church leaders invited American evangelist Franklin Graham to hold a Celebration of Hope festival in Sendai. It featured a number of Christian artists like Kirk Franklin and others.
1 year ago, we had tragedy in this community. Now we're having celebration and hope because we are reminded that God is sovereign and he's still on the throne.
He wants to bring fulfillment to your life.
Graham, son of famed evangelist Billy Graham, drew nearly 12,000 people over the three-day event.
I think for the first time, many Japanese people are open to the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Something Pastor Ikarashi Yoshitaka says he can testify has happened in the weeks and months since the tragedy. He co-leads a congregation not too far from the nuclear power plants.
This is going to be a sad and happy weekend. Sad because we will remember all those who died last year, but also happy because we are seeing God move like never before.
George Thomas, CBN News, Iwaki, Japan.